Hey everyone, this is Revan from Digio Integrative. Welcome to Tech News episode 237. RBI Governor Shaktikant Das retired the central bank worries about cryptocurrencies and its craze in India despite not being recognized as a currency. On the other hand, the Modi government and its department mooted for a strong regulatory control on cryptocurrency to avoid money laundering and terror financing rather than banning it entirely. Nowadays, a lot of applications are being infected with malware. The Joker malware has already been discovered in 7 Android applications, and these applications have been deleted from the Google Play Store after being detected. User may still have downloaded them and have them on their phones. This Joker malware is capable of infiltrating smartphones and subscribing users to payment services without their permission. WhatsApp has been available on computers for a while now, but it is essentially the mobile app adapted for desktop. According to a source from Italy, this will change in the future as the company is developing an entirely new application for Windows and macOS. Red light, green light mode is now available in Silly World Squid Royale. In anticipation of the upcoming Squid Game modes, over 700,000 players have pre-registered for the Squid Royale in Silly World. Silly World Squid Royale will get even more games from Squid Game in the coming weeks, including Tug of War, Dalgona Cookie, Marble Game, and a Glass Bridge, and many more. Instagram has started using a new method for identity verification of its users. The social media platform is asking users to take a short video selfie to help confirm that you are a real person. This feature has likely been introduced to reduce the number of fake or spam accounts on the platform. Instagram owner Meta promises that it will not collect any biometric data and this feature will only be used for identity verification and nothing else. And this identity verification ideally happens when a new user registers on the platform. So existing users are not being asked to go through the video selfie process yet. Amazon releases Prime Video app for Mac on App Store. Amazon Prime Video app for macOS comes with a picture-in-picture mode, AirPlay, offline downloads, and X-Ray. Users can also purchase or rent out movies or TV shows from the application. Hero Electric has announced a collaboration with the Bengaluru-based electric vehicle charging startup called as Charger. This partnership will result in 1 lakh charging stations across India in the next 3 years. Hero Electric in collaboration with Charger will set up to 10,000 charging stations across 30 cities in the first year itself. According to the reports, Google has confirmed to multiple supply chain sources that its Pixel Fold has been shelved and won't be released to the market. Though some outlets are reporting a cancellation, the report does not clearly specify whether the Pixel Fold is currently cancelled or delayed. Samsung Galaxy Tab A8 receives the Indian BIS certification and we can expect the launch to be very soon. Nothing Ear One may soon get a new black color option. The True Wireless earbuds were originally launched in white color back in July. Nothing Ear One black color option could be available in India as well. Vivo's upcoming flagship is set to feature a dual cell 4650mAh battery and supports up to 100W fast charging. Along with that, we can expect 4 flagships from the brand are coming up in quarter 1 2022. This includes foldables, slidables as well. The Vivo X80 series will be launching in India by late Jan or early Feb. The base variant may not debut, meaning the X80 Pro and X80 Pro Plus will be coming. The Vivo X80 Pro and X80 Pro Plus specifications are under wraps for now. Two upcoming Xiaomi devices with the model number L3 and L3A could be a long-awaiting mini smartphone from the company. Both the smartphone could be powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 870 processor. Xiaomi mini phone with the model number L3 is set to feature a 6.3-inch display. Using your eyes to control a computer or laptop might sound like a great way to free up your hands and boost productivity. But for disabled users, it could open the door to an online world many of us take for granted. Sweden's Tobii Dynavox has now bought its eye-tracking know-how to Apple's iPad, giving a voice to folks with conditions like cerebral palsy, ALS, and spinal cord injury. Tobii's TD Pilot is likely a chunky tablet case that brings native eye-tracking integration to an iPad. With the company's leveraging the power of iPadOS 15 to allow users to engage with social media, play games, line up entertainment, access educational applications, and so on using their eyes to control an on-screen cursor. The VIP mobile number was up for sale on BSNL's online portal. The number had been on auction for a week. A potato trader from Kota in Rajasthan came out as a winner with the outrageous bid of Rs. 2.4 lakh. Taiwanese semiconductor manufacturer MediaTek made a grand return to the high-end mobile chip segment with the launch of the Dimensity 1000 series. As MediaTek is planning to unveil a successor to the Dimensity 1000 processor, according to the earlier rumors, the next-generation premium chipset to bear the Dimensity 2000 processor. Battleground Mobile India is getting a new crossover with the new League of Legends Netflix series Arcane, which brings a new Mirror World theme mode. BGMI gets new gameplay features such as piggybacking and grenade indicators. Players who download the new BGMI 1.7 update will get two classic crate coupons. A data miner has compiled scripts in the newly leaked source code from GTA The Trilogy The Definitive Edition, which unearthed debug mode from GTA San Andreas. The leaked debug mode scripts also give insights into how the dev team might have created GTA San Andreas and worked on fixing issues. The compiled script has several tools to spawn vehicles, weapons, NPCs, and many more in GTA San Andreas. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.